morning, boss.
Good morning, Tatu. Let's go. Everyone, smiles.
Boss, that lady does not look too happy. Should I arrange for a cancellation refund?
Oh, no, no, Tatu. Miss Charlotte Johnson is a little disappointed, that's all. She had hoped it would be snowing.
Snowing? Here on Fantasy Island?
Well, anything is possible, my friend. You see, Miss Johnson's fantasy is to become a prima ballerina of ice skating.
She must be pretty good.
As a matter of fact, the only skating she's ever done has been confined to the frozen ponds around her family's farm in Minnesota, and that was some years ago.
In that case, I think she'll give you a big order, boss. I have faith on you.
Well, thank you, Tatu. That makes me feel much better.
Nice-looking couple.
Yes, Tatu. Mr. Jeremy Hale and Miss Linda Roth, his fiancée from New York. Throughout early years of constant practice and dedication, Mr. Hale dreamed of a great career as a concert pianist. Unfortunately, he discovered his talent was inadequate. So he now plays background music at fashionable New York restaurants.
Let me guess. He wants 1 week in a big time, like Carnegie Hall, the Philharmonic. Isn't that what he asked for?
How perspicacious of you, my friend. That is precisely what he asked for. And our job would be very simple if Mr. Hale actually wanted that fantasy.
You mean... that's not what he wants. You mean he's lying to us?
What Mr. Hale has in mind is much more complicated. It could prove extremely dangerous to him. Mr. Hale really wants to acquire the unique skills and genius of a dead man.
A dead man?
Yes, I do. One who may be seeking revenge from beyond the grave. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rourke, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island. Good afternoon, Miss Johnson.
Oh, hi, Mr. Rourke. Hi, Tatu. Oh, boy. That girl out there is... she's just absolutely...
breathtaking?
Oh, breathtaking. That says it.
Her name is Miss Laura Henderson, and she's competing for a place on the American women's figure skating team.
And she won't have any trouble either.
Oh, she's everything I've ever dreamed of being. Can you really make that happen for me? Can you turn a potato farm into poetry in motion like that?
I believe you said in your letter that you began skating when you were a child. Am I correct? What made you give it up?
Well, my mama got sick, so I had to take over her chores on the farm. Between that and school, there wasn't really time for my own interests.
So you have many years to catch up on. Well, in that case, I suggest you begin at once. Tatu?
Thank you very much, Mr. Rourke. I really do appreciate the thought, but I brought my own skates.
But this spear is special. No one knows who made them or even how old they are. But they are said to have belonged at one time to Miss Sonia Henning.
Sonia Henning?
That's before she won the three Olympic titles.
Why don't you try them out?
I practice for a competition.
What competition?
Your fantasy was to become one of the top women figure skaters in the world, am I correct? Well, naturally, you are entering the competition from which the American team will be selected. Good luck.
Mr. Rourke, I don't know how I'm going to thank you for giving me this job, letting me work my way through my fantasy.
You mean your wish to play the piano? Like this. The pianist is Mr. Sergei Marko, considered one of the most celebrated virtuosi of the 20th century. He died here on the island several months ago. I believe he was everything Mr. Hale ever wanted to be. Stop wasting my time, Mr. Hale. You are the older brother of Sergei Marko. You haven't seen him in several years. It hurt him very deeply. And he assumed you were jealous of his talent.
No, not jealous of him. Angry at myself. When we were kids, I loved him and my music. I took care of him, but he just had the spark. I didn't. Staying away from his world, it made my own easier to live in.
This was Sergei's ring. It was given to him by a European monarch. He never performed without it. When you put it on, you will play with all his passion and superb technique. Tonight is our annual Fantasy Island recital for piano. It is my hope that you will perform.
And when you finish playing, you will give it back to Mr. Rock, please.
As soon as possible. Play, Mr. Hale. Play along with Sergei.
Excuses. Batou? I've seen a lot of flying camels in my time, Henderson, but that looked exactly like a duck landing backwards. Now, do it again and get that back leg up.
Oh, boy. You've really gotten yourself in the hog pen now, Charlie girl. I just can't stand here all day.
Hiya, Mike.
Hi, Judge Meyer. Judge, do you know who that young lady is?
We never saw her before.
Time. Give a signal when you turn left, will you?
Oh, I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah. Well, nothing's coming apart. How about you?
Just dying of embarrassment. My first time on the ice here, and I have to fall in front of a man.
Well, as long as you had to fall, I'm glad it was me. Come on, let me help you up.
Thanks.
You all right? Sure you're okay?
Yes, thank you.
Madame Carla Marco, Sergei's widow. The gentleman with her is Mr. Vincent Stolman, Sergei's manager. They haven't been on the island since Sergei Marco died. We invited Madame Marco here for this year's recital as guest of honor.
He's copied Sergei's technique remarkably well.
Better than well. Deja vu.
He never finished writing it. How does he know it? Sergei's unfinished work. There was blood on the only copy. I burned it myself.
Shut up, Carla. We'll find out who he is and how he knows about it.
How?
You'll ask him when you go to see him.
Congratulate you, Mr. Hale. I'm Carla Marco. I heard you play tonight. You play remarkably well. Your technique is very like my late husband's.
I loved her. She helped kill me.
Mrs. Marco.
The composition you played tonight. Where did you hear it?
Punish her.
Mr. Hale, please. Where did you hear that composition?
I loved her. She helped him kill me.
Who are you?
Destroy her!
Oh.
Oh.
Murder! You helped kill me.
Jeremy!
I'll tell you, if I had the right girl with enough versatility and sheer physical strength, I could get her to go right from the footwork right into a series of stars and Arabians, and nobody could beat the program.
It can't be done. Nobody can make that move, no matter how strong. You tried it. Look what happened to you. Smashed your leg. Whipped yourself out of competitive skating.
Well, Miss Johnson, I've heard all about you.
It wasn't a complete wipeout, girl. Not as long as I'm still able to teach others.
The word's out that you're spectacular. You know, if it's true, you're going to be receiving a great many offers to turn pro after this competition.
You really think so?
Certainly. By the way, my dear, don't forget, you have to have your program form in by morning. We still don't know what routine you're planning to skate.
Well, I was just saving it as a surprise.
Well, I'm sure we'd all enjoy that immensely, Miss Johnson, but rules are rules.
The committee has decided that a skater without a program form has to be disqualified.
You mean I won't be allowed to skate?
If you don't have that form in by morning, I'm afraid not.
Oh, it's you. Oh, boy, I really did hurt you in that collision, didn't I?
No, it wasn't a collision, just an old injury.
Oh. I'm sorry to hear that, Mr. O'Brien.
Mike. And you're Charlotte.
Charlie.
You know, I gotta tell you, Charlie Johnson, you got Laura Henderson pretty worried. And me.
You can forget it. I'm out of the competition.
You what?
I don't have a freestyle program worked out.
You're kidding.
I didn't know about it in time. Guess it's too late. What's that?
Your routine for tomorrow night.
What?
Your routine for tomorrow night.
I couldn't possibly learn a routine by tomorrow night.
You said you wanted to skate, Johnson. Now, we skate by picking up one foot, putting it down, and then picking up the other. Now, skate! Sequence to go. If you can do it, there's nobody here who can beat you.
What about Laura? Why don't you teach her the sequence?
But Laura's not strong enough. She'd only get hurt if she tried it. Charlie, listen, please. Once in a while, somebody comes along that skates with her heart instead of her head, like Laura, you. But you have the physical stamina. You can be great. I can help you make it. Let me.
You believe in me that much?
I believe in you totally, Charlie. We'll skate. I meant to tell you, they're too old. They're unreliable.
But you don't understand. These aren't just any old skates. I can't perform without them.
Okay.
It's all so strange. I don't know what happened to me. It's as if she was my wife. I wanted to touch her, hold her, love her. And I wanted to punish her.
And, kill her?
I think I would have if Linda hadn't stopped me.
Mr. Hale...
Marco. I want to be called that now. I'm coming to terms with it. I'm Jeremy Marco, Sergei's brother.
That is correct. You are Jeremy. Not Sergei. I want you to look at something.
This way, please.
I have some photographs which might interest you. This was Sergei's home here on the island. It was here that he brought Carla, his bride. And this is where he died. I presided over the inquest myself as chief magistrate of the island. Madame Marco testified that Sergei took a walk that night along the cliff. Alone. He often did that when his music wouldn't flow, when inspiration failed him.
It's a word I never associated with him.
Our coroner concluded that the fatal wound on the back of his head was caused by a fall from the cliff.
Are you telling me something else?
Oh, there is some island gossip that Madame had begun to find much enjoyment in the company of her new business manager.
You think my brother was murdered by his wife and her lover?
Oh, there was no evidence for that finding at the inquest, no.
Yet it's so wrong. He wasn't a great Sergei Marko. He was just my kid brother. He still needed me to take care of me. He needed me more than ever. And what was I doing? I was so busy whining, feeling sorry for myself. God, I let him down.
I have a rule of not allowing a guest to cancel a fantasy once it has begun. However, in your case, I am asking you to allow me to end the fantasy. Give me back the ring. Now.
Do you have the power to take it from me, Mr. Rourke?
Not unless you permit me to.
And the answer is no. I still have some things to make up for.
If that includes being an instrument of your brother's revenge, I will stop you.
Oh, I'm sure you can stop me, Mr. Rourke. But can you stop a dead man?
Final three contestants will be Miss Laura Henderson, Miss Paula Fiorina, and Miss Charlie Johnson. And now, Laura Henderson.
Of course. What is it?
The skates you gave me. I put them in my locker and now they're gone.
I am very sorry to hear that, Miss Johnson.
You're sorry? There's one more performer after Laura Henderson. Then I've got to get out there and perform.
I wish I could be of service, Miss Johnson, but unfortunately that was the only pair of skates that could fulfill your fantasy.
Oh, gosh. I forgot. That's all this is just a fantasy. Fantasies have to come to an end.
Was not Sergei. His name is Jeremy Hale, and he's a piano bar player from New York.
Do piano bar players know Sergei's technique as well as he did? Do they know a concerto that only he knew? Do they know that we killed him?
Did he say so?
Yes! Yes!
All right, then. We'll have to take care of this person.
How?
If somehow, crazy as it sounds, if it is some manifestation of Sergei, well, I killed him once. I'll do it again.
A most stunning performance, Lucia.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Ward. Why aren't you out watching the others?
I wanted a word with you about a certain pair of skates that you might by chance have acquired.
Well, I have several pairs of skates.
This pair is special. They represent a dream.
What about my dreams? Mr. Rourke, I don't have a social life. I never have any time. Everything's always practice, practice, practice.
But you chose your path, Miss Anderson. Your tribulations, your sacrifices have nothing to do with anybody else. And that includes Miss Charlotte Johnson.
Well, she's interfering in my life.
Well, then fight back. But fight fairly. You have the talent.
Well, she has you on her side, and she has Mike. And she has those damn skates. It's just not fair. She doesn't know what sacrifice means.
I assure you, the fact that Miss Johnson hasn't taken the same path as you to get here doesn't make her dream any less important.
Look, I know you have another pair of skates. Use them. Don't quit. Not because of some hang-up about an old pair of skates.
Mike, you don't understand. I told you, I can't skate without those skates. They're magic.
Charlie, you're the magic.
What about your routine, Mike? Doesn't that matter? I can't do it without those skates.
The routine can go into mothballs for the rest of our lives. I love you, Charlie girl.
Got 2 minutes to get them on.
My skates!
Okay, come on.
Your attention, please. Miss Charlotte Johnson was scheduled to skate next, but has withdrawn from the competition.
I withdraw my withdrawal. I'm ready to skate now.
Well, then, by all means, Miss Johnson. Skate.
Charlie girl.
She'll do it, Mike. You'll see.
Charlie,
Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much. You've made me the happiest potato farmer in Minnesota. No, but seriously, I don't deserve this. It wasn't exactly me who did it. Oh, I can't explain. And even if I tried, you wouldn't believe me. Winning is important, but people also count. Hard-working people, dedicated people, like Miss Laura Henderson. She deserves to win. And that's why I'm going to withdraw again, this time for keeps. Thank you very much.
We commend Miss Johnson on her performance. She earned a perfect score.
However, since she has withdrawn once more, we declare the winner to be Miss Laura Henderson.
I told you. It's Sergei. He's waiting for us inside.
Now, you listen well, Carla. Whoever he is, whatever he's trying to do, we are going to end it. Right now.
About a husband, Carla?
What did I do to make you hate me enough to kill me?
I'm already dead, Vincent.
You took my wife, my money, and my life.
Over, Mr. Marco. Sergei wants revenge, not you, Jeremy. You want justice. I will see to it that it's done. Madame Marco, I think you have something to tell me. Something more than you told at the inquest.
Please, let me out.
Not until you answer me.
Sergei, he threw him over the cliff behind the house.
Your brother. He loves you, Mr. Marco. That's what he's telling you. He finished it.
his gift to you for bringing his murderers to justice. Now he can be at peace.
If you and Tattoo ever need anyone for the piano bar, I'll be on the next plane.
It's a deal. I will look to the entertainment schedule for an opening, and I will call you.
Mr. Hale, Mr. Marco, since the law forbids a person from profiting from a crime such as murder, Madame Marco will lose her right of inheritance. I'm sure that's the way Sergei would want it. Goodbye, and be happy.
We'll be happy, Mr. Rourke. We'll be very happy.
Goodbye, Mr. Rourke.
Thanks, Rourke.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Dear Mr. Rourke, I think they should go to Laura now.
Oh, she has no need. Please accept them as my gift, Miss Johnson, as a souvenir of Fancy Island.
Thanks. Believe me, they won't get rusty. They'll see a lot of duck ponds back in Minnesota. Thanks for everything.
You're very welcome, Miss Johnson.
Duck ponds? She doesn't know it yet, but those skates are going to get a lot of use at a new winter resort that I'm going to be managing. Up where Charlie lives. Come visit, Mr. Rourke.
Oh, well, thank you, Mr. O'Brien. I'd enjoy a winter vacation.
Great.
Can I come with you on your winter vacation?
Do you think you would enjoy that, Tattoo?
Of course. It's always so warm down here and sunny. I mean, it would be nice if we could go to a place where there are frozen ponds and wood burning fireplace. You know. Mom.